Good morning. Welcome back. Today is October 1st, 2023, the first day of October. I am at the Laurel Cemetery in Marietta. I came by to see a friend that I did a video on, Sierra Ann Estrada. If you haven't seen the video, please go back to my channel and check it out. She really deserves it, and it's worth a view, I promise you. It's not a waste of your time. But while I was out here, and I've been out here quite a few times, it's kind of weird that, for a better choice of words, certain other things have called to me here. This is a smaller cemetery. These three plots, every time I come here, there's either been something going on or somebody, so they're remembered. A lot of these people, this is a cemetery that always has family coming in and out. These three plots right here are the plots of, and excuse if I get the name wrong, Gabby Constant, Jessica Giraldo, and Marissa Garnica, which were on a soccer team. They were coming back from, I'm reading up real quick because I don't want to mess this up, and I'm going to go more into it. I wasn't going to film this morning, but I thought, I have the camera, I'm here, it's Sunday, I have Elvis gospel radio playing, just for whoever likes Elvis here. I mean, I think it's a pretty safe bet that somebody does, and I think it's a good message. So we have the Elvis gospel going on too, and I was like, okay, I can start this video. I need to read up more on it. I gotta look into it more, so that's why I'm using my phone right now to read the story. So let me give you guys a brief breakdown of what happened. Three women from Marietta and a man from Corona were identified as victims of a fatal crash, Highway 177, 19 miles north of Desert Center, which would be Palm Desert, Palm Springs area, Coachella Valley. They were coming back from Lake Havasu over the weekend. And according to the Riverside County, the victims, Marissa, okay, so let me get their ages straight. Marissa, 20, Jessica Giraldo, 20, Gabriel Constant, 20, and Matthew Hodges, 30. Now, Matthew was the driver at the time. The crash happened about 3:15. Hodges was driving south in a 2012 Toyota sedan. And what I heard, and how this is written is different, and I will look into it because I want to get the facts straight. I didn't hear he drifted. I heard he was on a one-lane, two-lane highway, and he attempted to pass in a small Toyota sedan. Attempted to pass a car that was going slow. I believe it was an RV. And that's when he hit a 1999 Freightliner semi-truck head-on. Now, the women were pronounced dead at the scene at 4:10 p.m. Crash happened at 3:15. More than likely, they passed away, hopefully without any suffering. The paramedics, however, airlifted Hodges, Matthew, the driver, to Corona Medical Center, where he passed away at 5:51 p.m. So they were on the scene pretty quick. I mean, there's probably a lot of people. It was a holiday weekend. Constant and Hodges were soccer coaches from Ruben Ayala High School in Chino Hills, the Glendora-based youth soccer program, Legends Football Club. The Legends family was dealt a life-altering news when two of our coaches, Gabby and Matt, were involved in a major car crash, and they succumbed to their injuries later. The truck driver was a man from Afton, Oklahoma. He was wearing a seatbelt, and he wasn't injured. It's semi versus small Toyota sedan. We know what's gonna happen. They did in fact rule out drugs and alcohol, so that wasn't part of it. Like I said, and I will read up more on it, I think he was just trying to pass a car, a slow car on a highway where, you know, you're driving with no stoplights through these small towns and right on cue a ray of light. And sadly, it happened. Wrong place, wrong time. So let's remember these girls. Let's remember Matthew as well, because it doesn't seem like it was anything intentional by him. They were just coming home from a weekend, like all of us have done all of our lives. So let's remember them. Like I said, this is going to be broken up because I want to get the facts on it more and let you guys know what happened and honestly speak on their behalf, because they all seem like very nice people.
We are a family. That's the bottom line.
Tonight, hundreds of young soccer players filled Ayala Park Stadium in Chino, holding flowers and each other, remembering two beloved coaches on a field they once trained with them on.
Gabrielle Constante was an angel. She was perfect.
Matt Hodges and Gabby Constante died in a freeway collision coming back from a river trip when they collided with another vehicle on Highway 177. Two others also died in the accident.
I still feel like I'm living a dream right now, and it's not a good dream. I want to wake up.
Matt and Gabby were Ayala High School's girls varsity head soccer coach and assistant coach, but they also had coached hundreds of kids over the years through the Legion's FC Soccer League. Some of the people they coached were their own family members.
Anyone who had a dream, anyone who loved soccer, she wanted to help them. She wanted to help them go to college. She wanted to mentor anyone she could. She was my mentor. She was our angel.
Many of their kids released hundreds of balloons into the air to remember 26-year-old Matt and 20-year-old Gabby, attaching handwritten notes inside for them.
One thing my brother was really, that I found out through this process, I kind of knew, is just how many people in the club, we have a big club, how many people he's been able to touch along the way.
As we make our way to the middle, you can see 1, 2, 3 plots. And let's pay some respect. And I think we will stop. We'll stop right here. And we'll start with Jessica Giraldo. And let's read her plot. She filled every second of her life with laughter, love, and happiness. Don't fear my love. Unlike others, my love does not fade. Jessica Kathleen Giraldo. So young. So she is in the center, and let's just say her sisters are with her right here. Make our way over here. We have Marissa Lauren Garnica, November 26, 1996, right there at Thanksgiving. She too, May 29, 2017. Like I said, they all passed away from their injuries, most likely instantaneously. And hers says, what makes life valuable is that it doesn't last forever. What makes it precious is that it ends. You must promise me that you will not hold on to hope. Keep it alive. We have to be greater than what we suffer. Marissa Lauren Garnica. Beautiful message. And as you can see, it looks that she enjoyed her eyelashes, and they're actually remembered right here as well. Beautiful. And we'll make our way just two down. And here we are. We have Gabrielle Marie Constant. Always remembering our beautiful angel, August 9th, 1996. Most importantly, no matter how hard a situation may seem, family can get you through it. Agreed 100%. Rest in peace, Gabby. And as we make our way from, well, we'll just step back a few feet. And I'll try to bring into frame, as you can see too, the three girls. I mean, we have Gabby, Jessica right here. And then we also have Marissa. On this Sunday, the first day of October, they all have some pumpkins out. Happy Halloween. One more thing I'd like to point out is from here, if you just turn directly left, we're in plot B. If you ever are out this way, there's a bench right here as well. Remembering the girls. And as we walk around this side of the bench, soccer sisters, may y'all rest in peace. God bless. Today is the 2nd of October, 2023, and we are back because I did want to follow up after the intro from yesterday and reading up a little bit more. And of course, the weed eater started right when I got here. So one thing I did want to go into was the driver of the car. His name was Matthew Hodges. He was actually the coach. Gabriella was the assistant coach. They were boyfriend, girlfriend. And they were the ones going, I'll try to talk over that. They were going, and then they brought their friends with them to go to Lake Havasu. So on the way back, as I was reading up on what happened, and as you've seen the clips that I've added in, Matthew Hodges, who I believe is buried in Riverside County, Chino Hills, possibly Corona, that area, Riverside. He's not buried here, but the three passengers were. One of the witnesses that saw what was going on that Labor Day weekend said that a lot of the cars were passing. The highway patrol believed the car was going 60 miles per hour. There was a lot of RVs, boats. The highway patrol doesn't believe he was trying to pass anyone. However, one of the witnesses that saw the crash, that tried to assist at the site of the crash, when he arrived, the only person alive still was Matthew Hodges with a severe head wound. He was actually flown out, and 2 hours later, sadly, he passed away too. So the girls pretty much passed away instantly, they say. And they were unsure if the passengers in the back were wearing seatbelts. But it looks like somebody's been out here even since yesterday. A car just left when I pulled up, but I just wanted to come out here and somewhat of a conclusion to this video. And such a horrific accident that happens every day. You never know what's gonna happen in your life. Anything can happen. You can lose your loved ones every time you walk out that door, and vice versa, every time you hang up that phone. So be sure to say I love you. And this was a tragic accident on what should have been just a fun holiday weekend. And I'm glad I was able to come out here, spend some time with them, and actually tell their story a little bit more. Hopefully it gets out there for more people to see, and just a group of friends that were way too young to have passed. And with that being said, send me a message. Leave a memory for them. Anything you'd like to say. Anybody, you know, I'm sure people have gone through this. I know I have in my lifetime. It happens all the time. It's a sad thing, but to the girls and Matthew, rest in peace. God bless. I did all that, and may I say, not in a shy way. Oh no, oh no, not me. I did it my way. For what is a man? What has he got? If not himself, then he has not to say. Yes, it was mine.